Hi, this is a quick video about how to check and set the Behringer Odyssey's power supply voltages. The first step before any calibration is always to check that the voltages in the synth are correct. To take the Behringer Odyssey apart, first unscrew the four screws on each side panel. There are 8 in total. Flip the synth upside down. Put something soft under it and make sure you don't damage the sliders. Undo the 6 screws on the bottom plate. Lift the back plate carefully, just enough to get your hands inside to undo the 2 cables and attach the keyboard to the main PCB. There's a clip with a hook on each contact. Press the clip and lift the contact out of the socket. Once the cables are out of the way, you can slide the bottom plate with the keyboard assembly out to separate it from the rest of the synth. Here is the main PCB. I've marked all the trim pots that are used to calibrate the synth. In most cases, there are no need to touch these unless you change the faulty component or there's some other serious problem. There are, however, 3 trim pots on the main PCB that controls the VCO's pitch and scaling, and they might require some adjusting from time to time due to the drift of analog circuits over time. Fortunately, Arp and Behringer provided easy access to this trim pot with 3 holes in the front panel. There's no need to open up the synth and adjust the pots from inside. At the jack panel PCB, there's a section that controls the voltages. To measure the voltages, you need a reference to ground. Here is a ground test pad to use with a negative probe or the voltmeter. To measure the plus 15 volt, touch a positive probe to the test point 2, labeled TP2. If the voltage needs to be adjusted, you can do so by turning the plus 15 volt trim pot with a small screwdriver. To measure the minus 15 volt, touch the voltmeter's positive probe to the test point 3, labeled TP3, and turn the minus 15 volt trim pot if need be. And here is a close-up. And now the lovely view of me actually doing it. The negative probe to ground, the positive probe to TP3, plus 15.001, perfect, I won't be touching that one. Let's check the negative then. Minus 15.014, not too bad, but not as good as the plus 15 volt. Okay, I need a free hand. I try to get a good ground connection with the probe in the chest screw hole. The other probe at the TP3 test point. Adjusting the minus 15 volt trim pot. Quite fiddly. I'm trying to get the feel for it here. It's quite sensitive. Just by removing the screwdriver, it changes the value. There, I think I nailed it. Checking, minus 15.001. Now they're even. There are also some test pads on the main PCB for factory testing. The ground is the unlabeled pad at the bottom, and the 15 volts are the 2 ones at the top. There's a slight voltage drop here, so the measured values will be slightly lower. Plus 14.98 and minus 14.98. That's good. Now, just put the synth back in the reversed order and we're done.